गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट क्लास 12th स्टूडेंट्स, इन लास्ट क्लास वी वर कंप्लीटिंग द चैप्टर फर्स्ट ऑफ यूनिट फर्स्ट विच वॉज रिप्रोडक्शन इन ऑर्गेनिज्म। स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस क्लास वी विल स्टार्टिंग the discussion about the chapter second, that is sexual reproduction in flowering plant. Students, today we will be starting the discussion about flowering plants and what about flowers. Do you know, students, what are flowering plants? Flowering plants are actually angiospermic plant. Students, that plant which are angiosperms are known as flowering plants because of these plants are characterized by presence of flowers and they are highly developed plant group which is angiosperm. And in the angiosperm, flowers must be present. Now, students, what are flowers? Flowers are actually reproducting units of the plant. Flowers are what? These are reproductive unit, or reproductive structure of plant. These are reproductive unit or reproductive structures of the plant in which reproduction takes place. Students, you are already known about flowers. Most of the points related to flowers are well known. And students, some points related to the structure of the flowers, you know that parts of the flower parts of the flower students, there are mainly two parts of the flower, essential part and non-essential part. Non-essential and essential part. Non-essential and essential part, students, according to the reproductive point of view or reproduction point of view, flower have two part, that is non-essential part and essential part. Non-essential part are so called because they are not very important or not important for the function of reproduction. They are only attractive part of the flower which include colored portion which include calyx and corolla. These are colored part of the flower which are not involved in the sexual reproduction. They are only attractive structure of the flower which help to attract the insect. for the purpose of pollination. So they are non-essential part of the flower because they are directly not involved in the process of reproduction. But essential part is the reproductive organ of the flower. Reproductive organ of the flower, which may be two reproductive organ, that is male reproductive organ or female reproductive organ. Male reproductive organ, students, stamen, and female reproductive organ, students, ovary. So both these are the essential part of the flower because of they are the main reproductive organ which are mainly involved in the sexual reproduction in the flower. So these stamens are the male reproductive organ of the flower and ovaries are the female reproductive organ of the flower which are directly involved in the sexual reproduction because of they have a capacity to develop gametes, that is stamen have pollen grains in which male gametes are present, and ovary has ovule or embryo sac in which female gametes are present, or you can say female gametes are developed or male gametes are developed in stamen. So these parts are mainly called essential parts according to the point of view of reproduction. So mainly two part of the flower is non-essential part and essential parts according to the view of reproduction. Now students, if you say common term according to the structure of the flower, then these calyx are actually sepals of the flower and corolla are the petals of the flower. So these are sepals and petals which are commonly used in the vocal language for the structure of the flower. Students, on the basis of presence of these structures of the flower, flower may be of two types. On the basis of presence or absence of parts of the flower, flower may be of two type: incomplete flower or complete flower. Incomplete flower or complete flower. Students, those flowers in which these four structures, that is sepals, petals, stamen and ovary or carpel, these are the parts of the flower. So those flower in which any parts of the flower are absent are called incomplete flower. Those flower in which any part of these are absent are known as incomplete flower, and those flower in which all these structures are present are termed as complete flower. Generally, in incomplete flower, these structures are absent, sepals and petals. Only stamen and ovary are present, which are mainly involved in the function of reproduction. But in complete flower, all these structures are present, including sepals, petals, stamens and ovary. So this type of flower is called complete flower, in which all these structures are present. Students, some technical terms are used in the flowering plants, such as students, if you remember in the class 11, when you study the families, three family which is mentioned in your anatomy, or you can say morphology of the plant, in which flower description are present in your syllabus. So you were see that what happened during the description of flower, what terms, what type of terminologies which are used in the description of flowers, such as some terminologies such as polyandrous flower, polyandrous flower, epipetalous flower, epipetalous flower, episepalous flower, and gynandrous flower, gynandrous flower, didynamous, tetradynamous, didynamous, tetradynamous, these type of terminologies used in description of the flower, and some other terms are also used in the description of the flowers. Polyandrous flower, what type of flowers are polyandrous? When all the stamens are free in endosium, all stamens are free in endosium, जितने भी stamens हैं सभी free होते हैं students, then this type of flower is called polyandrous situation. Epipetalous में stamen adnate with petals, it found mostly in gamopetalous corolla. Epipetalous means petals are actually, petals are, or you can say filament of stamen are attached with petals, filament of stamen attached with petals, filaments of stamen attached with petals, episepalous, stamen attached with sepals. पीपी सेपलस स्टेमेन अटैच्ड विद सेपल, स्टेमेन अटैच्ड विद सेपल्स. सो दिस कंडीशन इज कॉल्ड पीपी सेपलस. स्टूडेंट्स गायनेंड्रस व्हेन द एंथर ऑफ स्टेमेन यूनाइटेड विद स्टिग्मा ऑफ कार्पेल, एंथर यूनाइटेड विद स्टिग्मा ऑफ कार्पेल. स्टूडेंट डाइडायनमस कंडीशन, फोर स्टेमेन आउट ऑफ विच टू स्टेमेन आर लार्जर एंड टू आर शॉर्टर. फोर स्टेमेन आउट ऑफ विच टू लार्जर एंड टू शॉर्टर. दीज आर डाइडायनमस कंडीशन एंड टेट्राडायनमस. सिक्स स्टेमेन आउट ऑफ विच फोर आर लार्ज. सिक्स स्टेमेन आउट ऑफ विच फोर लार्ज एंड टू आर शॉर्टर. सो दीज आर कॉल्ड टेट्राडायनमस. दीज टाइप ऑफ टर्मिनोलॉजीज यूजिंग द डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ फ्लावर्स. सो सच अदर्स मोर टाइप ऑफ टर्मिनोलॉजीज ऑल्सो यूज इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ फ्लावर. स्टूडेंट्स सो यू सी दैट वॉट टाइप ऑफ टर्मिनोलॉजीज आर यूज इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ फ्लावर. स्टूडेंट्स एंड फ्लावर इज द एसेंशियल पार्ट ऑफ द फ्लावरिंग प्लांट्स विच मेनली इन्वॉल्व इन द प्रोसेस ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन. Students, these are the some points which are related to the parts of the flower and which are used in the process of reproduction. Some points according to the structure of the flower. Students, these are the stamens and this is the female portion of the flower, that is ovary. Students, in this part this is the anther in which this is called pollen chamber, in which number of pollen grains are present. These pollen grains contain male gametes, and in the ovary you can say it is the stigma, it is the style, and this is the ovary in which ovules are present. In the ovary, ovules are present in which female structure of this plant is present in this structure, which is called embryo sac. Embryo sac containing female gametes. So all these points related to the flowers were already studied by you in class 10th also, when reproduction in flowers you were studying. So these are the some points related to the flower. Students, in next class we will study about the structure, detailed structure of male and female flower, male and female reproductive organs of the flower. In the next class we will study about detailed description. Okay. Okay, students, so meet again in next class with description of male and female reproductive organs of the flower. Okay, thank you.